name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time as you are joining, inviting your fellows. Open your ears, attentive to hear this message. That's why you see this message is always, it's a spiritual warfare. Now, when message like this comes up, the demons that they manifest. They manifest and they start fighting so hard. So, but Jesus Christ is a winner and is a conqueror. He conquered him. So, whatever he's trying to do, he will not achieve, he will not succeed. He's still a loser. Therefore, I pray that God will help you. The video of yesterday, it will be on today, tonight, after this. So go and view it. Please go to our web, our YouTube and like the videos. Subscribe the videos. Send it to your friends. It is you who can make the friends, your friends, to discover and know the spiritual warfare. So if you have not subscribed our videos, go out there and subscribe it. Subscribe it. And the address of the videos is Overcomers DH Ministries. Overcomers DH Ministry. You will see all the videos. Or you can go to our website www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. So you could see all our videos and materials and information. So you like our videos. Also, we have Facebook. If you have not been like our Facebook, go to our website, our Facebook, Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry. Facebook, we have two pages. We have Christine Izigi and Overcomers. And then we have another one, Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry. Go there and like the page. Thank you very much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Izigi. Welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry. Thank you very much. I want to invite you once again. Newcomers, welcome. First timers, welcome. Thank you so much. If I didn't welcome you last time, I'm sincerely welcome you and enjoy this broadcast. God will help you. In Jesus' name, thank you. I'm going to talk to you the subject called Deliverance Prayer to Destroy Demonic Revival Activities. We have to stop demonic revival activities. Deliverance prayer to destroy demonic revival activities. There are demonic revival activities which is going around, which is going all over, even in the churches, even in the country. Demonic revival is reviving. It is really becoming more than even. Evil people are more than good people. If evil people want to fight, they will win. That's why we need to deal with them. We need to deal with the demonic revival activities. If right now the evil people want to say they want to worship anything, they want to vote that they should be a day for them to be a worship, they will win. Good people are not many. Evil people are more than good people. So it is our duty as a Christian, born again, we have to stop this revival, demonic revivals. The Bible tells us clearly in the book of 2 Timothy 3:2, and then I'm going to talk from verse 13. But the Bible says it is perilous time shall come. Men shall be lovers of themselves, seduced, dangerous time shall come. This is the dangerous time where the Bible calls it perilous time, where men, they love themselves, they seduce us, they dangerous, they are very dangerous. It is a time that, this is the time selfish. Men, they love themselves. It is the time that evil people, they are rising up than before. That's why we need to stop this. we have to stop this. By James 3, James 4, 7 says, therefore submit to God, resist the devil, and he will flee away. We have to resist the devil. The devil that is giving the demon authority to revive his activities, we have to resist the devil. We have to resist the demon. We have to resist the powers of the devil so that they cannot continue reviving the activities, so that our city can be saved, so that our community can be saved. Satanic people are reviving the activities than the revival of Jesus Christ. Now everybody is following the way of the world. Therefore, I pray that God Almighty, by the power in the blood of Jesus, let the Bible, as it says, resist the devil and the devil will run away. Let us resist every activities of the devil. Let us resist every evil that is going on so that it can fly away. There is no point you sit down and watch the activities of the devil reviving, continue around your community, around your workplace, around the church, and you are not doing anything. You just cross your hands like this, you watch. That's not nice. It is in the last days, evil men and seduced folks stronger, increase and become weak. They become so wicked. It is important for us to make a connection between the prophetic and the demonic activities. So if we make connect with the prophetic, to prophesy against them, to speak the word against them, and to put a stop of these demonic activities, they will lose, they can't continue, they can't pass their law. First Peter 2 says, therefore, rid yourself of all malices and all deceit, hypocrisy, envy, and slander of every kind. This is what the Bible says. Get rid yourself of malices. All these things, malices, hypocrisy, envy, slander, and all every kind. It is giving the devil activity to work. It is giving demons illegal right to revive and to revive more and more in the life of people. So when you stop hypocrisy, Christian, people of God, stop hypocrisy, stop envious, stop slander and every other kind of evil. You know that you are envy, you are jealous and envious. You know you are hypocrisy. You pretend. Hypocrisy is to pretend that you are doing the right thing and you are not doing the right thing. This is to give the illegal power for the demonic world to revive. I am going to pray that everything that is working against you to make the devil to be revival, to make Satan to revival, to be destroyed in Jesus' name. We have to know how to put this demonic revival a stop, because they are moving. They are bringing some churches down. There was a church in England, a big church. This church was turned to a home. There is no wrong a church there. Big, you see, if you see these big churches, you find few people, like 10 people. There are only 10 people. The demon, they have revived and they have taken people out. When you see what is going around the world with young people, with things which is going on, you see the demonic now, they are revived activities. They are taking everything. If you see in the television, everything you see there is demonic. Most of them, there is nothing good. So if you have put your life in the TV, watching TV throughout, then you will make the devil demonic revival activity to continue. If you love things that which is not glorifying God, you will make the devil to be revived. You will make the demon revive activities. That's why we need to pray that God will help you. God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, thank you for giving me hearts. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I don't know, somebody struggled to come in. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes. Some people, they are trying to come in, but they can't find the way to come. That's why I have to look at this. And let me turn it off so that it cannot bring destruction. I am praying that we should know how to address these activities. We should know how to, which kind of the prayer that we pray so that this will destroy demonic revival in your community, in your church, in your workplace, so that they cannot have power. You can stop them. When God was talking to Abraham, and Abraham, when God wanted to destroy the Sodom and Gomorrah, God talked to Abraham and asked, Abraham negotiated with God, begged God, said, God, there are a lot of people there at Sodom and Gomorrah. There are so many good people who loves you. God told him, no, if there are people, I will spare them. Then they negotiate, they talk, until they reach like 10 people. God tells still, if they are good people, 10 people, I will spare the country. But now Abraham said, God, do your will, which means that there was no good people in Sodom and Gomorrah. Now, it will not be like us. It is not going to be happen in your community or your workplace. There must be good people there. So you will stop every activities of the enemy. You will stop every demonic revival in your work, in your place of work, in your community, in your church, so that they cannot continue reviving. We have the revival of Jesus, the revival of the gospel. But now you see, it is opposite. Now demons, they are reviving the activities more than the church. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you, Father. I want to thank you. We want to be like Elijah. Elijah made demon cry for mercy. He worried the devils. He gave wicked rulers sleepless nights. Elijah make the devil to cry. He make the leaders sleepless. We know Elijah, what he was dealing with the leaders, with the enemies. We know David prayed against the enemies, and he never lose. He was winning all throughout. We see that is the same thing that we can go like David prayed. Like David, the way David was doing his spiritual warfare. When he sees that the demonic is reviving, he could call, he could compose songs and praise God and start cursing and command the revival of the demon to stop, the revival of the demonic activities to stop. And that's how he was winning. Now the demon, they have legal rights. They come and bring sickness and disease. They start tormenting you. They torment you. They torment you. They take everything from you. And you are a child of God. Remember, the memory fast all the time. Remember, Jesus himself gave you power. This power Jesus gave to you to trumpet on serpents and scorpion. Have you ever tried to trumpet on serpent and scorpion? Have you tried to trump on serpent and scorpion? You take your legs and you say, today I'm going to trumpet upon you, you serpent and scorpion. Have you ever trumpeted on serpent and scorpion? Or you just read the word and you leave it like that? You can command them, you just bring them to your feet and you step on them, you step on them, you step on their head, you step on them, you step and you trumpet on them until they are destroyed. Remember, Jesus came to destroy the works of the devil. So it is your responsibility to destroy. That's why I gave you power. That's why Jesus said, I have given you power to trumpet on serpent and scorpion, and nothing by all means shall hurt you. We don't need to let this revival, demonic revivals, to continue reviving. So because we have been given power, we have to stop them. If we stop them, they cannot have access and start torturing. The demons, you know, the Bible says scorpions and serpentine, and serpent, snake and scorpion. Snake is Satan. Scorpion are demons. They are very dangerous. If they poison you, you are dead. You are finished. So now, when these scorpions are sent, they inject you with poisonous. And when they inject you, you go and turn yourself to something. Turn yourself a man to man. Turn yourself a woman to woman. Turn yourself to animals. Yeah? Turn yourself to something else. When they inject you, because they tell you, go and do this, go and they make their ministry to be revived. That is their work of the demons. They are looking who is weaker, who is weak in prayer, who is prayerless. Then they inject you. Now, when they inject you, you can't pray. You can't even sit down. You try this, you try to pray, you become prayerlessness. Now, when you can't pray because the devil does not pray. The devil fears prayer. Now, when they have injected you, now you cannot be prayed. Then they can come and torture you the way they want. They can bring sickness. They can come on your neck and hold your neck and beat your neck. They can come on your head. They started beating your head. They can come anywhere because they have a legal right to come in. Now, I pray that in your life, let the revival of God fall upon you. Let God himself revive you, not the demon to revive you. You have to set fire against demonic revival activities. You command them, every demonic revival activities in my life, in my environment, in my ministry, let them catch fire. Let them be destroyed. I destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. You go to your workplace or your business. You look at your business. You say, any demonic revival activities in my business shall be destroyed by fire, shall be rendered powerless. That is how you can pray deliverance prayer to revive. You can go to your place of work and you look at the place of work. You command every demon, every evil around that place to be melted by fire. You command that every operation in this ministry, in this company, operating by the demon, every activities of the demon in this company, I command them to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. And let every demonic revival in this company be destroyed. Yeah, you go there, you command them, you take dominion over that building. That company, you take dominion. Children of God, people of God, you should know how to take dominion. You should be a star. You should be a light. Even if they have said that you can't preach in the church or at the workplace, like here in Canada, now you can't say anything at work. You can't, even in school, you can't share the word of God. But they have not shipped your mouth. You can take dominion over that building. You can take dominion. You can stop operation of the demon that is operating in that place. Yeah? You can go there. Anywhere you go, you stave your feet. God told Joshua, everywhere you put your feet, you will take over. You take that place. It is yours. So wherever your feet is stepping there, you claim that place, you command the revival of the demon to be destroyed and be bound to useless and be rendered powerless in Jesus' name. This is a big revival. If you have not, the revival I was given this not long ago. So the revival of the demon must be stopped, must be destroyed in the name of Jesus. So you have to declare a war against satanic revival. Yes, let me write this. This is another topic. Satanic war against satanic revival. Yes. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Yes, my God. Thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. We need to set a war against satanic revival. That has been reviving and destroying many lives. The devil has been destroying so many lives. This is the work of the devil. Look at that, the book of 2 Timothy 3, verse 13. The Bible says, but evil men and imposters will grow worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. They grow worse and worse, deceiving, and they will also be deceived. They deceive people, and also they are deceived. That is what the Bible says. 2 Timothy 3 verse 13. But evil men, imposters, yes, will grow worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. That's why you see in 2 Timothy 3, 2, it says that the last day, perilous times come, many will be lovers of themselves and seduous, dangerous time. People, they love themselves, they don't care, selfish, they don't care anything, they don't care anybody, it is them, only them. They don't look at anybody, this is themselves. Those are the demonic revival activities. It is that, it's the time, that's what the Bible says. Look at that scripture again. Read the book of 2 Timothy 2. Because they have done that, and then God said, okay, continue what you want to do. But our God is God of mercy. God who forgive people, and is God who will restore back what the enemy has taken. God our Father is a loving God. Jesus Christ loved us so much, so that we cannot allow these demons to continue growing in our society. We have to put a stop to them. We have to command them to be destroyed themselves. We have to put themselves a stop. Generation coming now, people, they will know, they will grow, they know that they can turn themselves to the same sex. They have no problem with that. If everybody can do that, where would the children come from? I'm not judging ever anybody, because judgment, we are not allowed to do that. But this is what the Bible says here, that the demons, they have been revived activities, and it is growing. It is growing big. It's growing big. I was in Africa. A man changed his name to be called the name of a woman. And this man refused to be a man. He wants to become a woman. He refused completely. He went to the court and they changed. And they went and changed himself to become a woman. You see, he was a man. He was born a man, but he refused to be a man. He wanted to become a woman. So they said, okay, that's fine. It's your choice. We are not stopping you this. So now the demon that was operating in his life was revived, so he won. Now I'm praying that God will destroy every activities of the demon that is reviving in your life. The demon that is reviving in your life to make decision, wrong decision, let them be wasted. Let them be rendered powerless in Jesus' name. I'm going to pray with you. Let all evil arrows from demonic agents fashioned against you receive the fire of God and melt to ashes in the name of Jesus. I am praying that every all evil arrows from demonic agents fashioned against you to receive the fire of God and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. I am praying by the power and the blood of Jesus, let the power and the anointing of God that breaks every yoke fall upon you now, and break all evil chains, evil fetters, and evil bands off from your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Give me hearts. I want to see the hearts. I know you are trying to write. You will write them. Don't worry. If you want them, call me. I will give them. I know that you want these prayers. It is okay. But give me hearts. I want you to punch so much. I want to reach 2 million. And I don't know when I'm going to reach 2 million. 2 million hearts. Yes, God is good. I pray that God, every evil, every door of evils that has touched your life for evil, let it receive the tormentment of the Holy Spirit and be converted and confused in the name of Jesus. Every door of evil that has touched your life for evil, receive the tormentment of the Holy Spirit and be converted and confused in Jesus' name. You know there's power that will touch you. When they touch you, you start, it will infect you to go to evil, to start doing evil. You stop doing the right thing, then you do the evil things. Let that power to be destroyed and let the blood of Jesus wash you in Jesus' name. I declare that every pronouncement from demonic agency against you shall not stand. Nature shall become to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, I prophesy to you right now by the power in the blood of Jesus. I declare that every pronouncement from demonic agency against you shall not stand, neither shall they come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, let every demonic dispatched against your life receive confession and fight themselves in the mighty name of Jesus. Every satanic revival in your life and your family, let them be confused. Let them fight themselves. Let them render powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. Every agent of demonic from demonic world, they have assigned to come and destroy your children, to come and destroy you and your family. Let them confuse themselves and go back and destroy themselves in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, thank you. Any familiar spirit representing you in the dark world, I command them to fall down and die in Jesus' name. I pray every dark projection and manipulation against you, I command them to be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, my Father and my God, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty, every investigation demon, guiding demon, and a dedicated demon assigned to your life, I command them to receive the fire of God and be separating from you in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that there are demon, investigating demon, wherever you are, they come and investigate you. This investigation demon, they can come like and friends to you. They can come to as a friend and they can offer you gifts. They can look good to you and they want to find something from you. And after they find something, they will destroy your life completely. They are called unfriendly friend. And now, these unfriendly friends, they are called investigator demon. These investigation demons, when they are assigned to the company or they are assigned to their church, they will come and pretend that they are so good. If they have been assigned, you know, I see them all the time in my ministry. They come there, they come with a group of people. They can come with 10 or 5 people. And they will look good. They will look good. They will do everything. But they have been assigned to come and achieve their mission. But every time, because I've been given very sharp discerning, and we pray the prayers, that every investigation demon that has been signed into our ministry, expose them and disgrace. Now, when they come like friends, now their time, it comes and they are disgraced and run away. You should know who is your friend. Many, many, many people that are suffering in this investigation demon. They come to your life. You are happy. You say, I've got a friend. I've got someone whom I can talk to. I can tell them what I'm doing. After telling them, that is the end of your life. Look what happened to Diana. She died because of evil investigation demon. She thought that she can share with the person who was thinking that she's alive, but in return, it become negative. So those are the demon investigation. When they come to you, they pretend that they love you. They talk to you nice. They can give you a cup of tea. They can give you Tim Horton. They can give you gifts. Then check. Any good deal, think twice. Think why somebody is so kind and so good for you. Why? Yeah? Don't trust people like that. Take your time before you trust them. Because many of you, when you come, look at this. I found information. Many pastors in the internet now, most of them, they say they are not married. Because women are desperately looking for men. And most of them, they are satanic people. They have been given money from Freemason, from Illuminati, to recruit women, and they are looking for wealthy women. When you join them, they will talk nice to you. They will say, okay, I will pray for you to get a husband. I will marry you. I've no, and that's what is going on. Many women have landed in their hands. They have lost their houses. They have lost everything on their hands. Eventually, they kill them. So don't be led by them. If you see a pastor who is saying that he's not married, he can marry you, he's looking for a woman, don't rush, please. Don't rush, please. Take your time. Take your time and watch the person. Because they have been assigned, there are many, they found that the church, many people, they are calling, they need help. So because of that, now these people have assigned their agents. They are on the internet. Yeah? And they see you like paper. They can tell you everything. Then you say, yes, it's a prophet. And it's a satanic prophet. So these are the ones who will destroy your life forever. You will never recover. You will never be the same again. I pray that let those investigation demons to be destroyed and be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus. Every demonic bad luck and chains used against you in the dark world, I command them to catch fire and cut to pieces in the name of Jesus. I pray that God, Almighty God, King of Glory, Jesus Christ, every evil dominion and control in your life by evil spirit, I command them to break by fire and be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. I thank Jesus. I thank God because God is here and is destroying the works of the enemy. I command them. I release you. I release you from every negative subjection to anything or a person to be anything. Yes, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I want to thank you, Lord. I bless your name, God. I pray every evil tie, evil rings, evil bands, protection to manipulate you, to manipulate your life. I command them to catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, my Father, I am praying evil ordinance against your life. I command them to come out and I render you powerless and avoid in the name of Jesus. Let the spirit of confusion come upon every satanic agents, satanic priests and prophets hired against your life in the mighty name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I breathe the blood of Jesus. I pray that let confusion, let the angels of God bring confusion to these satanic agents, satanic priests, and prophets hired against your life and your family. Let the fire of God bring them and bring to confusion in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray you satanic priest and prophet hired against the life of this person. I command you to drink your own portion and fall unto your evil desires in the mighty name of Jesus. You priest, you satanic priest and satanic prophets and pastors, you are a liar. You have been hired by demon, by Satan to deceive people. I command you to drink your own blood and eat your own flesh in the mighty name of Jesus. You are deceiving people. According to the book of Timothy, that says that many will be deceived. They will deceive and they will deceive too. So the demons that has been hired, the agents of darkness, Satan has hired priests, prophets, pastors, they are pastors, they are satanic pastors, they are the satanic priests. They have been hired to deceive people. I pray that let them drink their own blood and drink their own and eat their own flesh in the mighty name of Jesus. They will not locate you to deceive you. You will come out like a bird coming from the gate in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that God will cover you. You will not be. God will recover you from the wicked people. God will recover you from satanic priests. God will recover you from evil prophets in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, I want to thank you, Father. Lord, I want to bless your name. I give you all the glory, Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Every counselors and decision by satanic priest and prophet from your life shall not stand neither shall they come to pass in Jesus' name. You satanic priest and priest and prophet hired against your life, I destroy you. I command you to be confused in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. God, I want to thank you. Every evil that has been said, has done in your life, I destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, my God, I want to thank you, Jesus. Every demonic point of contact to ladder of your destiny, I command them to catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, I want to thank you, Father. I want to honor you, God. I glorify your name. I thank you, Jesus. I give you all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord. I praise you, God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Every demonic revival into your family, into your life, into your church, into your workplace, let them be destroyed. Let them be destroyed. Let the fire of God consume them. Let the fire of God burn them to ashes. I cut them off. I cut them off. I command them to come out in the mighty name of Jesus. To come out in the name of Jesus. I bind them and I destroy them. I render them powerless. It will not manifest in Jesus' name. I destroy every demonic, satanic revivals in your ministry, in your church, in your workplace, wherever you are, in your house, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Father. Father, I thank you. Father, I praise your name. I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Yes, I want to thank God for you. Thank you. Thank you for joining. Thank you for coming. I have to stop here. Tomorrow we are on 12 midnight. Come and join us. Invite your followers. The videos will be there and it will help you. Thank you once again. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye to you. Remember to visit our website, www.overcomers.com. DHministry.blogspot.ca. God bless you. God bless you so much. And I know that you may want to have our number. Our number is 877-241-3420. That is top free number. So you can call us if you are in North America. You don't pay. That is free number. And you can call us from anywhere in the world, 905-487-7196. Or you can use our cell phone number, 647-608-5207. So you are welcome to call all this number. It is there. It is for you. Now, if you need prayers, I will stand with you. We have to put a stop of this demonic revival. Not to continue reviving. Not to continue to go on. Thank you, Treasure. Thank you so much. We have to destroy these demonic revival activities. Everywhere you have, you take dominion. Treasure, when you go to that company, you take dominion. You say, my feet is in this company. I take dominion. Every satanic activities revival in this place, I destroy you. You take dominion. Anywhere you are going, those who are having working in these companies, working in an organization, child of God, take dominion. They have to obey. Everything has to obey you because you are a child of God. You have authority. Jesus has given you authority and power and trumpet every demon that is operating there in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. See you tomorrow at 12 midnight and we shall continue. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. Because Jesus loves you, so I love you too. Thank you very much. Bye. Bye-bye.